We've seen an extraordinary level of demand from all kinds of investors, long-only investors, hedge funds, and sovereign wealth funds. People really liked three things about our business. That it's scalable, it's profitable, and sustainable. And once they got familiar with our business model and got convinced in those three things, we had lots of good feedback and lots of demand for our shares. And on the back of this feedback and demand, we decided to upsize our transaction to approximately $2 billion in order to allocate more shares to investors.
Anton, a cynic would always ask, I think, on an IPO, why are you selling it to the public when the existing owners could enjoy the fruits of the profit if there are still good times to come here? We've had your rivals X5 and Magnet on the program, and they're all after the value end of the market where you operate. Have you had the best of the profitability in the near term?
Well, the good thing about this business is that, I mean, the variety value retail or dollar stores, how they are called in the US, is that it has been around for decades. And investors are comfortable that this business model is here to stay despite different challenges like online, attempts of the food retailers and the like. Therefore, we don't think that we have any problems going forward with growing our business. In fact, we have bright future ahead of us. And it's just the company got to a point where it's big enough and it needs to become more institutional. And that's what we are doing with this transaction.
Anton, we've been discussing the pivot towards digital sales during the pandemic, and I was struck by some of the data we saw from Gap, a very different business model, of course, when we talk about clothing, but they got about 45% of total sales and now digital. When we talk about your business in the variety space and much lower price points, just where are you in the journey towards digital and where do you see it going?
There are two things people really value about dollar stores and variety value retail. That's convenience and price. And those two things which online can't really compete on, and we don't believe it would be something that they would ever get to. If you look at the US markets, for example, which is very well penetrated, then the likes of Dollar General, Dollar Tree, Five Below, they coexist very nicely with Amazon and other online retailers. Russia has a long way to go to get to this level of penetration. And in any case, we don't believe that due to our very low price points and the value proposition we are giving to our customers, that it would be a threat to us in the mid to long term.